Hey everybody, Facebook Live, Anchor.fm, all that good stuff. Going back to back, wanted to talk about don't let anybody guilt you into investing. You know, the talk of the town, especially in the you know, the woke community right now, is the Tulsa Real Estate Fund. Also, you know, people talking big about Bitcoin, big about Forex, big about different MLMs, whatnot. And, you know, when people are trying to sell this to you and it's one of those things that you have to buy right at now, get it while it's hot, always take your time. Never lean on your own understanding because, you know, if you don't know, you don't know, and you can't make yourself know, and you just have to study the market. And I'm not talking negative about any of these as long as you get educated in what it really is. Because, you know, people are hitting me every day asking about Tulsa, and you know, I'm telling them, hey, schedule an appointment and let's talk about you first. Then we can talk about the Tulsa Real Estate Fund, because this could be a great thing that I've known a few people who have tried to do, you know, land investment. And a lot of times when you try to do this type of group economics inside the Black community, a person gets hit with some type of charge, whatnot. And God forbid that happens to Jay Morrison. But, you know, you got to keep that brother in prayer, because they do not like this, the masses. You know, when they say, who's the man? Hey, majority of people aren't bad people, and I don't even think are racist, but there's certainly an agenda to keep certain people in a certain area and don't get too big. You know, they show how they humble us. So, you know, with research, all of these things could be million-dollar, multi-million-dollar things, but the problem is enough of you don't study. You know, and what they do, and I want to get off Tulsa when I say this next thing, just like Bitcoin, I know many people who have lost their hat in Bitcoin because they invested in Bitcoin or Litecoin or all these cryptocurrencies, never read a white paper in their life, don't know who started it. All they know is they heard on the news, propaganda again. And if you trust your local news, my goodness, you need to see who's paying their bills. And read and research Orson Welles and how this whole thing works, whatnot. But, you know, people are losing their whole hat because they don't understand that Bitcoin, cryptocurrency was for the criminals. Now, I know they're trying to, you know, put a good brand on it and talk about who's made this, and read the white papers before you buy anything. Get into the deep web real quick. You don't even know how to get in the deep web, but you want to get on this crypto. You know, I would just say educate yourself on Bitcoin. Educate yourself on Forex. See why, you know, majority of people fail in Forex and Bitcoin and MLMs. These are not get rich quick things. These are learn the market, and then you can win, you know. But they know that the majority of people are going to fail. What's going on, Islam? What's going on, Will Boney? Man, Will probably flying through the sky in the G4, you know. But, you know, get people who are smarter than you. So when these great investments come that these regular people are asking you to spend money on, and acting like your money, it's just a small investment. Well, if it's a small investment, you pay it, and I'll pay you back double. You know what I mean? If it's that small. But get educated. Read. Research. Get around crews that are smarter than you. So often, you know, even if you're smart out there, people will come up to you and they'll say, hey, you got a good network. And they want to pull from your network and pull from your resources. And they want to pull them until you do something that they don't understand themselves. And then they want you to teach them, and they want that free game from you. Man, ain't no free game out here. You got to go to that cprfirm.as.me and schedule a time, and then you can go. But no one has time to give you any free game in this this United States race that everyone's running, at least in this country. You know, no chill. But this is why you fail, because you just don't know. And look at the people they target. You know, MLMs target poor people because they know you need more money right now and you don't have it, but they make it affordable so you can get on. There's nothing wrong with that if you're willing to work the plan, but you have to ask, what happened to the other four plans that you had in life, and why did you fail? And it was probably because the lack of ambition, the lack of follow through. You know, many people that we see, they couldn't keep their word if it would save their life. You know, remind you like an old Twilight Zone episode, black and white. Like, you're just a liar. You're going to need some magic to come make you tell the truth. But, you know, my cousin Bon Bon, she had told me something that about myself that I didn't even, you know, when you just living the life, you just doing you. But she said, the thing about you is you got that hustle and you've always had it, and you're going to go get what you want, you know, by any means necessary. And, you know, and that's not a straight quote, but she was like, the hustle that you have, everybody doesn't have. And she wasn't trying to gas me up. She wasn't making an excuse for herself. You know, she's about to be Dr. Bon Bon in a couple of years. And she was just telling me how, you know, it's unique that you can find somebody. And others have told me that. They're like, man, you just don't give up. Well, I want something. And we didn't give up as kids when we wanted something, whatever that thing was, we're going to get it, you know, by hook or by crook. So yeah, that hustle and in me, it's just that I want it and I feel like I deserve it. So I'm going to go get it. And you can't tell me anything different. And what I tell people about investment when they come and say, well, should I invest in this? Should I get this stock? Should I get this Bitcoin, this Forex? And a lot of people don't like me talking negative about these things because I'm messing with their money. But you know, I really don't care what you think about what I'm talking about on my platform, right? Because those people talk from a distance. And they never, you know, in a intelligent conversation, one-on-one, can talk like that, because Forex, MLM, Bitcoin, many investments, you're probably not going to win. You probably don't have enough money to get into the real investments that you do win. And when you do have that money, they put you on a waiting list and make it feel like it's some special opportunity, whatnot. And you have to understand, when you are investing, what you're investing in. Is this something that you like to do? Or is it just something to just get a quick flip, get some quick money, whatnot, you know? And there was something on here on the Bitcoin, you know, people told me I lost a bunch of money. And it's, again, I've talked to so many people who've lost money because they did not understand. And like, well, Kellen, why didn't I talk to you beforehand? I said, I don't know why you didn't talk to me. I can't answer that question, why you didn't talk to me. And there was a thing on the MLMs, how MLMs will ruin your family. It was somewhere on here. And I'm like, my goodness. And MLMs could ruin your life. That's what it was. And I thought about family, because for the person who is barely making it and they're living check to check, and they tell them, go ask your friends and family first. And then your friends and family get into something that you're not even going to win at. And then you all are losing. And now they don't trust you. You know what I mean? And that's all bad. That's all bad. So that hustle right there of get your friends and family, I can't get my friends and family on no MLM. You know, look at me like, dude, what's going on? You know, and I've tried the MLM, but I took it from another route. And it was a real player route where it was all students when we were in college and we're learning about this business. And, you know, almost took an L, because I sold thousands of dollars worth of travel in the first month, but there was a limit where you could get your money back, get your 500 back. Man, I sold so much, and they don't expect you to sell as much as I did. I had all the Grambling and Ruston buying tickets on the Lolo. I was beating out Southwest. And then I saw those little checks that they sent, and I said, this isn't what it was supposed to be. I need my money back, and I need this commission too. You know, this little 2 cents, two coins that they were given. So, you know, but they don't expect you to win. And when you do win like that, you know, I get calls to this day from people. Oh, we got a new thing going. Would you come and bring your network? And could you bring, you know, celebrity? And now, you know, celebrity is just an influencer. Could you do that? And no, I couldn't. And I never used any of those connections to do anything because it's tacky. And those people don't want to get involved in that and then sell it to their people and their people lose money. Like, you don't have any ethics. You don't understand that you can only burn certain people once and it's on and popping, you know. And I don't want to see those people while I'm eating dinner with my fam. Like, I owe them something. So, you know, multi-level marketing, that's not for me. But I know people who are multimillionaires in that. And I think they do it quite ethically. And they put a team behind them. But that's a lot of investing in people. That's more time that I've seen them do throughout the years than I'd want to put in people personally. You know, I'm a consultant. And I like to be creative. And I like to kind of do what I like to do when I want to do it and change my website the way I want to change it and build it the way we want to build it. Not how a bunch of, you know, thousands of people have gotten together. And that's just the way I like to live my life. And, you know, to me, MLM just doesn't work. Even though I know I'd be great at it. And people say, oh, you'll be great. I know I'll be great at it. Whatever I do, I will be great at, you know. And I don't have to justify my greatness and how that looks to you. Because many people, this thing of when you do make a win, people flashing money online and big stacks, and half of it is fake money, borrowed money, their rent money, their car payment that they can't afford. Like, is this why we're getting money? Is this why we're doing business? Just to flex on people and make other people feel like a certain way? That's not why I do business. That's not why I live my life or anything, you know. And I'm not an expert in any of it. When people say, oh, man, you really know this thing about Litecoin or whatnot. Oh, Forex. Somebody had once said on my Instagram, seems like you really know what you're doing. Man, we're just playing around on this thing. You know, kind of figure out things quickly. And that's just one of my gifts. You figure out something quick and say, okay, yeah, this will work. This will work. And also how to beat the game. I was never one who wanted to play the game. I want to beat the game. And I want to beat the game sometimes with the cheat codes, old school Nintendo, blowing the casket or the cassette, whatnot. You know, it got too hot. And that's when the game started cheating on you. So I want to beat the game. I don't want to play the game. And then I want to be quiet and I want to relax. And, you know, you don't have to know who I am, the young Al Heyman. And that's cool. And that's cool for me. So I say, if you don't let people guilt you into investment, don't make them feel like, oh, it's just a little bit of money you're going to miss out. Because I promise you, when people start talking like that, they are shysters. They are not, they're serious about their money. But you getting your bread, forget about it. You know, it's just not happening. And we see a lot of that. You know, if you're broke, learn something that you are somewhat gifted in. Or, you know, if you like to read or you like to watch videos, do that. If you like to do social media, there's people who all they do is, you know, get on social media all day, but they've mastered that. Master something and then learn how to sell that to somebody. You know, but it's not a guilt thing. When you see all these people in rented cars and they're going to dealerships and taking a 15-minute free ride, whatnot. You know, I see it. I see it behind the scenes because we saw it when artists would do it. You know what I mean? And, you know, even you get a helicopter and you paint your name on it one day, it's cheaper than buying it. But, you know, don't feel duped into this social media society where people only show you the good, but they don't show you when they had, you know, $80 in the account after they had paid payroll, paid for all the stuff they wanted to flex on the gram. Like, it's not that serious. And it doesn't matter if you are a lawyer or a lawnmower, you know, just pushing a lawnmower. You know, it's a lot of faking out there. And you shouldn't let anybody make you feel that you're not worth something because you can't do what they're doing at that given moment. Because, you know, I truly believe that happiness and that wholeness has to start within. It has to be in you. It just can't be on you. Money and clothes can be on you. And, you know, and people, when they say, oh, money can buy happiness, they ain't got enough of it to know that. They haven't even seen enough in the world. They're trying to sell you something 9 out of 10 times. I ain't got nothing to sell to you, but to tell you, be the best you, do your purpose. Some people are meant to work a job. Just because you're not an entrepreneur doesn't mean you're not successful. I personally would like to see more entrepreneurs and see everyone at least do one business, but that's more for their family than to, you know, be flexing and saying, oh man, I'm doing it. I never had a job. I'm self-made. Like, that foolishness, man, you skip me with that. That's when we step back and disappear, man. Catch me in Okanda, whatnot. And you don't have a pass to go because it's my zone, my world, wherever I'm at. But do not be guilted into doing any type of investment, even stock. You know, if you don't understand the stock market and people tell you, oh, this is a great deal, and educate yourself. If you'd read more, if you'd hang around a circle that was bigger than you that maybe you don't even understand. You don't understand the terminologies, but you learn. You don't understand the music. You don't understand the jokes. You know, that's who you need to be around. That's who you need to be around. And that's why we push this, you know, bridge to Africa, because there's so much that an American can see and vision in Africa. And if you had an African friend and you connected the same way when immigrants come over here, see how they get business, they see all the opportunities. You don't see all the opportunities because you're brainwashed. But there's opportunities. You don't anything that you'll sell to an employer, you could really sell to the government. You could really sell to a private company if you knew how to present it right. And that's why we do the consulting. I love making an entrepreneur. Forget the money. We don't have to talk about the money. People, you know, will tell you so quick. I met someone the other day, and he was so quick to tell me the millions and billions. And it's like, man, I know you faking. And I could prove that in 3 different ways that you don't have it like that. But, you know, I like to kind of hear that, you know, that gas talk sometimes. I'm not going to lie. And I keep some people around who do just talk like that. Just because, you know, it's fun sometimes. And it doesn't affect my money. And it's interesting. But, you know, you may not vibe with that. So don't be guilted. I'm out. You know, I'm being too long-winded on this, but don't be guilted into investing. You do what you can do at your time. Don't use your last. Don't sell your car to get in a high-risk investment. Now, low-risk investment, and you can, you know, put some chips up, do it. But I'm going to be out. Hope you guys enjoy this summer. You know, hope you just write. Get your book down. Everyone at least has one book in them, you know. And I'm out, people. Blessings.